Okay, so let's try to answer this question. So the question is, what are the basic entities managed by SAP Business Objects Risk Management, right? So the point is we have to answer this question based on the basic entities managed by SAP Business Objects. And the answer choices that we have are, first one is business and reputation, second one is clearing and forwarding, third one is risk and opportunities, fourth one is sales and marketing. So give this video a minute's pause and maybe less than that, and then try to come up with an answer choice. Then we will go ahead and see what is the right answer. I hope you are back and you have your answer choice in your mind. So let's try to analyze all these answer choices. The first one is business and reputation, right? So do you think this is the right answer? This is not the right answer. Why so? Because business and reputation, this is something which is very broad term, generic statement or generic terminology which has been given to us as an answer choice. So this is not an answer, right answer choice. So the next one is clearing and forwarding. So do you think this is the right answer? So if you want to see what is clearing and forwarding, these are the business activities, right? So these clearing and forwarding are nothing but the business activities. Business activities, right? And mostly these are related to the finance module. No, this is also not the right answer. Okay, so we'll go to the last option, which is sales and marketing. So again, sales and marketing is something which is very broad in nature and very generic answer choice that we have over here. Okay, so we are left with risk and opportunities, so that's imperative that this is the right answer. But we will see why this answer is the right answer choice and what is risk and what is opportunities we have mentioned over here, right? So let's suppose you want your business revenue to raise by 50%. This is a KPI that you have set for your business, right? And when you are very close to quarter three, when you are very close to quarter three, you figured out that you are off track. Getting a 50% revenue increase is not possible, right? So at that point in time, you have got into a risk zone, right? So this is what this risk part covers. But what opportunities? So let's suppose again, I'll take the same scenario wherein you have set a KPI of 50% revenue increase in quarter three. So we are very, again, this is the case number one, which already discussed. This is case number two. Let's suppose you are very close to quarter three end, and you figured out that you have already achieved 48% of the revenue increase, and you still have 1 month to spare, right? So at that point in time, what you will try to do, you will try to exploit opportunity, or maybe, right, you will try to make the revenue more than 50%. So that is something which is classified as opportunity, right? And that is what mentioned over here. So the right answer is risk and opportunities.